Hello friends, welcome to Smash the Shell. I am Amit Kumar and in this video tutorial we're gonna learn about collapsing margins and CSS. Collapsing margins are really crucial to understand for every CSS developer. Whether you have just started to learn CSS or writing CSS for years, it is really important that you familiarize yourself with the concept of collapsing margins so that you can easily deal with the unexpected behavior caused by the margins when particularly working with the adjacent elements margins. Also, it will help you to create a better vertical rhythm, be it typography or layout. So let's get started and figure out what is collapsing margins. Well, the answer to the question above is pretty simple. Collapsing margins occur between two vertically adjacent elements if their margins are touching. Whenever the vertical margins of vertically adjoining elements are collided without having any resistance between them, such as borders or paddings, then these margins will combine to form a single margin that is going to be applied between these vertical elements. And the single margin that is going to be considered as the actual margin is greater among all the margins. The smaller margins are discarded and collapsed to zero, and the margin that will be applied is the greater among all of those margins. So now let's see when margins are collapsed. For every element that are in normal document flow and block level element, the margins are always going to be collapsed. For the elements which are vertically stacked and have margins applied are always going to collapsed if they are block level element, and vertical margins of parent and child elements are also going to collapsed, and it is applicable only for the first child and last child of the parent element. And for the last child of the parent element, it is only going to collapse if the height of the parent is set to auto instead of a specific height. Vertical margins of empty elements are also going to collapse, so you have to remember this point. Now let's see when these margins will not collapse in our next slide. Okay, so for the every positioned element, be it absolute position or fixed position, these margins will not collapse. Also, for the floated and cleared elements, the margins will not collapse. For the inline block elements, it will not collapse. And for the overflow set to anything except visible, also margins will not collapse there. And the most important is that for the root element, in case of HTML, that is HTML element, the margins will not collapse. So let's deal with the case one, where vertical margins of two vertically adjacent elements are collapsed. Understand how does it work and how it behaves when margins are applied to these two elements in the same direction. Here is the simple demonstration that I have created. A block level element A and a block level element B. For the element A, I have a margin bottom of 30 pixels. And for the element B, I have a margin top of 20 pixels. Now, what do you think, guys, will be the final margin that is going to apply between these two elements? Can you just guess it based on the previous explanation? Okay, so let's see. It's going to be 30 pixels. But some of you might expect something like this. You may think that margin should be like this. Margin bottom should be 30 pixel to the bottom and 20 pixel to the top. But in reality, we are just going to get this margin bottom 30 pixel because it is the greater among these two values. So we are going to get 30 pixel margin bottom. Now here's the clever question. What happens in case of negative margins? Well, that's a very interesting case here. Let's see what happens. only the absolute maximum value will be applied. And what do I mean by absolute maximum value is that the higher value or higher negative value is going to be applied if both the margins are negative and applied vertically. Let's see a demonstration to understand this. Again, we have two elements A and B. For the element A, I have margin bottom of negative 20 pixel, and for the element B, I have margin top of negative 30 pixel. Now, what will be the final margin? It's going to be minus 30 pixel, and it will just push our element B upwards and overlap over the element A, and minus 30 pixel is going to apply to the bottom of this element. That makes our elements to push upward by 30 pixel. So whenever you are going to an interview and asked by an interviewer that what causes an element to overlay, they may give you some options like overflow, z-index, margin. So you have to remember that margins always going to make any elements overlap one another. So it's not the z-index, neither it's overflow. Now let's look at another case. When only one margin is negative, what will happen? What do you think, guys? Well, in this case, the final margin will be the result of subtraction of negative value from the positive one. Means we have to add these two numbers, negative plus positive, and then we will get the final result to be applied as a margin between those two vertically stacked elements. Here's a simple demonstration. Again, we have two elements, right? For the element A, I have margin bottom on 30 pixel, which is positive, and for the element B, I have margin top of negative 20 pixel. Now, what do you think, guys, will happen here? We simply add these two numbers like this, and we're gonna get 10 pixel. Negative 20 pixel plus 30 pixel is going to give us 10 pixel. So our final result of margin that we are going to get is margin bottom 10 pixel for the element A, not margin top minus 20 pixel. So now let's see another case. Vertical margins collapsed between parent and child elements. As I have already told that this is applicable only for the first child and last child of the parent element. So let's see the first situation where first child element of the parent and margin top is applied to child element and the parent element. So let's see a simple demonstration here. A parent element, a child element inside it, and a simple paragraph above the parent element. Alright, so let's go ahead and apply a margin top of 20 pixel to the parent element. Now you can see that our paragraph is pushed upward by 20 pixel. Now let's see what should not happen when I just go ahead and apply margin top to my child element. Margin top 30 pixel. This shouldn't happen if your user agent is implemented correctly in your browser, if there is no padding or border to the parent element. In reality, these margins should always collapse, so the real result will be different. In reality, the collapsing always going to happen. So the real result would look something like this. We are going to get only margin top 30 pixel. It will push our paragraph element to top by 30 pixel, and it is applied outside the parent element. So this is kind of unexpected behavior you might haven't think about. But there is a solution to this problem. We can simply use paddings or borders or any non-empty content to separate these margins so that they cannot collide. So let's see again this demonstration. Again, we were looking for this kind of result, then we have to apply a padding or border to our parent element to separate these margins so that they do not collide. So to get this kind of result, I have to apply a border something like this to separate these two margins. This margin here, that is 30 pixel, to the top of my child element, and 20 pixel to the top of my parent element. So this is how it can be done. Let's look at another case. Last child element of the parent and margin bottom. As I have already told you that bottom margins will only collapse when the parent height is set to auto. So let's see the demonstration for this. Again, we have a parent element, a child element inside it, and a paragraph now to the bottom of my parent element this time. Now let's see what happens when I just go ahead and apply a margin bottom 20 pixel and margin bottom 30 pixel to the child element. Okay, so let me explain you. Here we have margin bottom of 20 pixel and margin bottom 30 pixel to the child element. Which margin is going to be considered here? Since these both margins are collided, that's why the margin bottom 30 pixel is going to take over to the margin bottom of 20 pixel. That's why we are going to get the 30 pixel margin bottom, and that is going to apply outside of my parent element, and it will push our paragraph downwards by 30 pixel. And this is only going to happen if and only if the parent height is set to auto, as displayed here. So friends, this is all you need to know about collapsing margins in CSS. And yeah, if you want to see how this all works in real world with the help of code demonstration, please don't forget to watch that video. You can find the link at the end of this video. If you like this video, please don't forget to hit like to this video and share it with your friends and subscribe to this channel. Bye bye, take care, see you in my next video.